Hi, my name's Bronwen. I work at the Cambridge University Botanic Garden, and I'm going to talk a little bit about quadrats and how to use them really easily in your school grounds or your local playing field to study grassland ecology, the kind of plants you might get just on your school lawn. So there's a variety of quadrats you can use or have at your disposal. One of the most kind of commonly seen ones is an open quadrat, so this is a rather large example, and this is just a really easy, quick way to define an area within which to look at plants, and you can compare two different areas that look different to you when you're just standing there looking and seeing which plants are in each. So that's your open quadrat. If you don't have any open quadrats at your school, you can really easily make a homemade version. So this is just a coat hanger that you can pull open to make a rough square shape. So a quadrat doesn't have to be any particular shape or size, as long as it's the same in each place that you're placing it, that's fine. So this would be do the job just as well. You may have also seen quadrats a bit like these ones. So this is a gridded quadrat, and it can be used in the same way, so comparing two different areas and looking at the plants within each of those areas. So this is obviously one that's been bought, but you could make your own version out of some fencing, so quite nice and flexible, and again you can place it on the ground and just have a look at the plants under. Okay, so here we have a gridded quadrat, and this one is 10 by 10 squares, so in total our area is 100 squares, or 100%. If we think about the squares making up 100%, then each square is 1%. What you want to get your students to do is to look into each of the squares in turn, methodically, and think about whether the square is half or more full of a certain plant. So if I was to start down here and look at grass over the whole of the quadrat, we could count up. So in this square, it's probably just about covering half or more, so you get 1%. There's nothing in this square, so we wouldn't count it. Third square, there's half or more, so that's another percent, 2, and so on. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 for the first row. We continue that all the way up in your 100 squares, counting whether the grass is present in half or more of each square. And this just allows your students to look a little bit more closely in each of the squares, making up the quadrat. Again, comparing one area to a second area. So you don't need to worry at all if you don't know anything about plants or any of your plant species, it doesn't matter. As long as you can tell the plants apart and that they're different from each other. So if we were to take this area here, you can get your students to look at the leaf shape. Sometimes it's handy to turn the leaf over as well, so you'll see this one on the back has nice distinct ridges. So this plant here has slightly longer elongated leaves with ridges on the back. Right next to it, we've got something that may at first glance look similar, but it's actually got much rounder leaves. If we turn it over, no ridges. And it actually feels slightly different too, because you feel the hairs on the leaf.